Hello students, let's start IIT worksheet question number 12. See now in question number 12 there is one correction. See it is given ABCD is a square. Cancel this square. And what you are going to write? Quadrilateral. ABCD is a quadrilateral. What you will write? Quadrilateral. ABCD is a quadrilateral and change the diagram also. Draw like this diagram. It is given square, na, don't keep that square. Make it quadrilateral. Okay. So ABCD is a quadrilateral. P is a point in its interior. P is a point in its interior. See. P is point in its interior. It is interior. Such that triangle PAB is equilateral. What it is given in the question? Triangle PAB. It is equilateral. It is shown. It has told. It is equilateral. See this symbol, what it shows? These three sides are equal. Okay. Then measure of angle PCB. Okay, now ABCD is a quadrilateral. In that triangle PAB is equilateral given. And what it is given? This side also it has shown with this side equal. See, this sides are also shown same like equal. Okay, now see, PAB is equilateral triangle. Means each angle is 60 degree, you know. PAB is equilateral triangle. So each angle, equilateral triangle means its all sides are equal and its all angles are equal and each angle is 60 degree. Okay, now what it is shown in the diagram, these sides are also shown the same, equal. See, sign is given, see double lines are given for to show the equality sign. Here also double lines are given to show the equality sign. See. Okay, so this triangle also it has shown the equilateral. Suppose now this triangle it is given equilateral. Now in question it is given this triangle equilateral. And sign, see what is the sign for this? This side is equal. So this side is also equal. So this and this triangle also equilateral triangle. So what is the measurement of angle PCB? So angle PCB is equal to 60 degree. So what is the major angle PCB? See, triangle PAB is equilateral triangle. Yes, it is given. Yes, why it is equilateral? It is given. Okay, so each angle 60 degree, equilateral triangles, all angles are same and each angle it is 60 degree. In equilateral triangle, all angles are equal, angles and all sides are equal. So each angle is 60 degree. So now what it is given, see, it has shown in the diagram, these two sides are also equal, it has shown. This already it is shown in this triangle, but here it has shown with equality sign. So triangle PCB also equilateral. So triangle PCB is equilateral triangle. Triangle PCB is equilateral triangle. It is also given. See, equal signs are given. So this is also given. So equilateral triangle means all angles are equal and each angle is 60 degree. So measure of angle PCB, therefore angle PCB is equal to 60 degree. Therefore angle PCB is equal to 60 degree. See, you have to change the diagram because that diagram is wrong. See, that diagram is wrong. So here change the word square, write there quadrilateral and change the diagram and then find the answer. Okay. Let's solve question number 13. Two chimneys 18 meter and 13 meter high stand upright. See, this is 18 meter chimney. Chimneys, you know, See, this distance is 18 meter, okay? 18 meter. Two chimneys, 18 meter and 13 meter high. So, another is 13 meter high. So, if we will draw, this is 13 meter. Okay? Two chimneys, 18 meter and 13 meter high. Two chimneys, 18 meter and 13 meter high. Stand upright on a ground. Stand upright on a ground. Standing on a ground. Stand upright on the ground. If their feet is, this. If their feet is 12 meter apart. If their feet is, how much it is? 12 meter apart. So this distance is 12 meter. So this distance is 12 meter. Okay? See, two chimneys, 18 meter and 13 meter high, stand upright on a ground. If their feet is, see, their feet is 12 meter apart. Feet is 12 meter apart. Then the distance between their top is, we have to find distance between their top, means these and this distance we have to find. Then find the distance between their top is. This is the top of 13 meter chimney and this is the top of 18 meter chimney. Okay. Okay. So now, what we can do in this? What we can do in this? See, this distance is 12 meters. So I will give the name A, B, C and D. Okay. Now see, if this distance is 12 meter, this distance is 12 meter. So if you will draw, if you will join this line for this chimney. See, if you will join this line, it has formed the rectangle. It has formed the rectangle. So this distance, see, this BC is 12 meters. So how much is this distance? This distance also 12 meters. Okay. This distance also 12 meters. Okay. So now, if you will see, this AB, AB is 13 meter. Now here I will give name E. Okay. AB is 13 meter. Then EC. See, it has formed the rectangle. It has formed the rectangle. See, AB is 13 meter. Then this opposite side to this, it is also 13 meter. This also 13 meter. See, this total BC is 18. But now CE, how much we got? 13. Then how much is the distance of DE? What is the distance of DE? What is the distance of DE or ED? Okay, so ED is equal to, how can we find this ED? From total, how much is total DC? CD minus, if you will do CD minus CE, CE, you will get the distance ED. You will get the distance CD. So CD, how much it is? CD is given 18 meter. CD is given 18 meter. And how much? CE, CE is given 13 meter. CE is given 13 meter. Okay. So 18 minus 13, how much we got? 5 meter. So ED, how much we got? ED, we got 5 meter. ED, we got 5 meter. ED, we got 5 meter. See, 13 plus 5, 18. So total CE, how, CD, how much it is given? Total CD, it is given 18. 18, from 18 we subtract 13, how much we got? ED. ED we got 5 meter. Okay, so ED we got 5 meter. This distance we got 12 meter. And what we have to find? Distance between their tops. So see, I will join their tops. I will join their tops. Now join the tops. Now what it has formed here? What it has formed here? Triangle. Yes, it has formed here right angle triangle. See, when you join this, line we got here, this is hypotenuse and these are the two sides of this triangle. Okay, so now what is the formula? How can we find this distance? AD square, hypotenuse square means AD square. This is hypotenuse. It has formed a right angle triangle. Here it has formed a right angle. It has formed a right angle. So this is hypotenuse. So hypotenuse square means AD square is equal to AE square plus ED square. AE square plus ED square. Okay, now AE how much it is? 12 meter. So 12 square plus ED how much it is? ED 5 meter. So 5 square. Now find the squares of this. 12 square, 144. What is the square of 12? 144 plus 5 square. 5 square is 25. 5 5 is 25. Now do the sum of this both the number. 5 plus 4, 9. 4 plus 2, 6, 1. 169. So AD square how much we got? 169. AD square how much we got? 169. Now what we can do in this? Finding the square root of both the sides. Finding the square root of both the sides. Now what is the square root of AD square? AD square means AD multiplied by AD. So square root means we have to take 1 only. So AD will come here is equal to. Now 169 is the square of 13. What is the square of 13? 169. So what is the square root of 169? 13 is the square root of 169. So AD we got 13 meter. AD how much we got? 13 meter. The distance between their top is, the distance between their top is 13 meter. The distance between their top is
18 meter. See, this total distance is 18 meter. See, this distance, total distance from here to here, it is 18 meter. Okay, two chimneys 18 meter and 13 meter. This distance is 13 meter from here to here. This distance is 13 meter. Okay, means this AB is 13 meter. High stand upright on the ground. If their feet is, their feet means this. Feet is 12 meter apart. 12 meter apart means this distance is 12 meter. Then the distance between their top is, then we have to find distance between their top. So it was not there. So what I did, just I joined this. It has formed a rectangle. When I join this point to this line, then it has formed the rectangle. Now see, rectangle means if this side it is given, this, this feet is given 12 meters. So this also it will come 12 meter. So we got here this distance is 12 meter. Now total CD is 18 meter. Now this 13 meter, we join this. So this is rectangle, so opposite of this side is also 13 meter. Okay, so now what it was asked in the question, we have to find their top. So this we got 13. So 18, what we find? This distance we find. 18 minus 13. How much we got? 5 meter. See, CD minus CE. CD minus CE. What we got? ED we got. That is 5. Now here you have got the triangle. Right angle triangle you got. So now this is hypotenuse. So hypotenuse square is equal to side square plus side square. Hypotenuse AD square is equal to AE square plus ED square. So AD square is equal to AE, how much it is given? 12 square. AD how much it is given? 12 meter. So 12 square plus ED how much it is given? 5 meter. So 5 square.
Okay, so now AD square is equal to 12 square 444 plus 5 square 25. So find the sum. AD square we got 169. Now AD square we got 169. Now we have to find the square root of both the sides. What is the square root of AD square? AD. AD square means AD into AD. So we have to take one time AD. We took. Okay, what is the square root of 169? 13. See. What is the square root of 169? 13. 13 square is 169. So square root of 169 is 13 meter. So the distance between their top is 13 meter. Let's solve question number 14. Two angles of a triangle are 60 degree. Then the triangle is, then which type of triangle it is? See, suppose this is triangle. In this triangle, two angles are given 60 degree. Two angles of triangle are 60 degree. Then the triangle is, then which type of triangle it is? See, if this 60 degree, this 60 degree, then obviously third angle is 60 degree, because sum of the measure of all the angles is equal to 180 degree. Now see, 60 plus 60. Let's find this angle. X, okay, this angle which we don't know, okay. So what you will do? 60 degree by angle sum property of triangle. 60 degree plus 60 degree plus angle X is equal to 180 degree. So 60 plus 60, 120 degree plus angle X is equal to 180 degree. Why we have to do 180 degree? Angle sum property of triangle by angle sum property of triangle. It is 180. Okay, so now angle X is equal to, now 120 is here plus, if we will transfer to that side then it will become minus, so minus 120 degree. So angle X is equal to 60 degree. So angle X also we got 60 degree. Now this, all the angles are 60 degree, means which type of triangle it is? Equilateral triangle. All angles are equal and each angle we got 60 degrees. So which type of triangle it is? This triangle is equilateral triangle. Two angles of triangle are 60 degrees. Then the triangle is equilateral triangle. Question number 15. In triangle ABC, see here I will draw the triangle ABC. In triangle ABC, if angle A, see this is triangle ABC. If angle A is 65 degree. See, always draw the rough diagram for this solution. Okay. In triangle ABC, angle A 65 degree. Angle C is 85 degree. Then find the major angle B. For then angle B measures. What is the measurement of angle B? Now, angle by angle sum property of triangle we have to solve this. Okay. So angle A plus angle B plus angle C is equal to 180 degree. Why? Sum of the angles of a triangle is equal to 180 degree. Okay. So now angle A is given 65 degree plus angle B it is asked. So angle B we have to find. So write as it is plus angle C it is given 85 degree. Is equal to 180 degree. Okay, now do the sum of these both the numbers 65 degree and 85 degree. 5 plus 5, 10, 1 is carrying, 8 plus 6, 14, and 150 degree we got here, plus angle B. Okay, plus angle B is equal to 180 degree as it is. Okay, now this 150 degree is here plus, if you will transfer to that side then it will become minus. So angle B is equal to 180 degree minus 150 degree. So angle B is equal to 30 degree. So what it is asked? Then major angle B. Angle B is equal to 30 degree. So question number 16. In the given figure, angle A is equal to 50 degree. This angle A. Angle A is equal to 50 degree. CE parallel BA. CE and BA are parallel line. And angle ECD. Angle ECD. This angle is 60 degree. See this angle. 60 degree. Then
find angle ACB means this angle we have to find. It is how much? Okay. So now if you will see in this figure properly, CE parallel BA. What is given? CE parallel BA. It is given. Yes. It is given. So AC is the transversal. AC is transversal. AC is transversal. So angle A is equal to angle ACE. See, this angle, this is transversal and these two lines are parallel. This is transversal. See, these are two parallel lines and this is transversal. So these angles are these angles. ACE. Angle ACE. Both are equal because alternate interior angles. Because alternate interior angle. Angle A and angle this. ACE. Angle A is equal to angle ACE. ACE. These are equal. These are equal. Angle A is equal to angle ACE. These are equal. Why these are equal? Because alternate interior angles. Angle A and angle ACE. Angle A and angle ACE. These both are equal. Why? Because alternate interior angles. These both the angles are alternate interior angles. Therefore, angle ACE. How much we got? Angle ACE 50 degree. Why? Because angle A and angle ACE are equal. Angle A, how much it is given? 50 degree. So angle ACE also 50 degree, because these both the angles are alternate interior angles. So angle ACE we got 50 degree. Okay. Now see, we got this angle 50 degree. We got this angle 50 degree. Okay. Now what we can do in this? Now what we can do in this? See. What we can do, how we can find these angle, remaining angle. See, it is 60 degree, it is 50 degrees. So how to find these angle? How to find? These are the supplementary angles. 60 degree plus 50 degree plus these angle. Okay, so these angle how much will, what it is as ACB. So these angle we will consider X. Okay, these angle we will consider X. So angle 60 degree plus angle 50 degree plus angle X is equal to 180 degree. Angle 60 degree plus angle 50 degree plus angle X. This we have considered the angle X, which we don't know. Angle ACB only we have to find. So this, or you can write here angle ACB also. But consider X, we have to find this. So write here X. Okay. So 60 degree. Why 180 degree? See, these angles are supplementary. These angles are supplementary. So 60 degree plus 50 degree, 110 degree plus angle X is equal to 180 degree. Okay. Now angle X is equal to, now 110 is here plus. If we will transfer to that side, then it will become minus. So minus 110 degree. So angle X is equal to 180 minus 110, 70 degree. Angle X means which angle? Angle ACB we got. Therefore, angle ACB is equal to 70 degree. Angle X means which we got? See, angle X we consider for this. So angle ACB, how much we got? 70 degree. So the angle ACB is equal to 70 degree.
Krishna,
represented in the given figure side BC of triangle ABC, side BC of triangle ABC is produced to D, that angle ABC is equal to 70 degree. Okay, angle ABC is equal to 70 degree and angle ACD is equal to 120 degree. Then angle BAC is equal to how much? BAC means these angles we have to find. Which angle? These angles we have to find. Okay. What is D1? This is triangle ABC produced to D such that angle ABC means this angle is 70 degree and angle ACD means this angle. This is exterior angle. So we can use the exterior angle property. ACD is equal to 120 degree. Then angle BAC, how much? So we have to find this angle. Angle BAC. Now exterior angle is equal to sum of the opposite interior angle. Okay, exterior angle is equal to your length. This is exterior angle and these are the interior opposite angles. This is exterior angle and these are the interior opposite angles. So what we'll do here? Exterior angle is equal to sum of interior opposite angles. Okay, angle ACD is exterior angle is equal to sum of the interior opposite angle. Which are the interior opposite angle? Angle ABC, angle ABC plus angle BAC. Plus angle BAC means these angle plus these angle is equal to exterior angle. Okay, so angle ACD, how much it is given? 120 degree. Angle ACD is given 120 degree. Angle ABC, ABC how much? 70 degree. ABC is 70 degree. Plus angle BAC, BAC that we have to find. So keep as it is angle BAC. Okay, now 70 degrees here plus if we will transfer to this side then it will become minus. So 120 degree minus 70 degree is equal to angle BAC. Okay, so 120 minus 70, how much will get? 50 degree. Okay, 120 minus 70, 50 degree. So angle BAC, how much we got? 50 degree. Angle BAC, and that only it is us. What angle BAC is equal to how much? Therefore, angle BAC is equal to 50